up. Welcome to special interviews. It's our honor to have a Nobel laureate, Professor Harald Sørensen, with us today. So he got the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine 2008 for his discovery of human papilloma virus causing cervical cancer. Right. So we have some questions that I hope you can inspire the young generation.
Okay. Try my best.
Thank you. Thank you very much. We start from, what do you love the most in science and research?
Science is most interesting because, first of all, it satisfies your own curiosity. Mm-hmm. And secondly, also, if it can be applied, and that's what we are trying to do, it may help the patients and avoid suffering of the patients from cancer specifically. So I'm working all my lifetime in cancer, and that was indeed one of the major aims.
It's great purpose. So how come you get a good question for your research?
Well, the question came up during my medical training. Mm-hmm. Because as a student I saw that some bacteria change their properties.
Yes.
And it picks up the nucleic acid, the mm-hmm. genetic material of the phage of the virus, the bacterial virus. And that they, for instance, regain properties like toxin production and something else become indeed pathogens under those circumstances. And that triggered the idea that the cancer might be due to a similar mechanism, namely that the cell picks up and virus, the genetic material persists in the cells and under certain circumstances may be activated to turn the cell into a cancer cell. And that really, this idea followed me after today, my life.
So it's very new idea in science.
At that time it was relatively new, yeah, but of course animal systems existed already. It showed that something like this is theoretically possible.
In your opinion, generally, how to get a good question in science?
Well, of course, a few aspects which you need to consider. First of all, you need to have some time really to consult yourself by reading a lot of literature mm-hmm. and finding out where the problems are. Yeah. That's for a young person sometimes very difficult to identify a good question. But basically, if you become aware of a specific area which interests you very much, you will sooner or later you will learn that there are a couple of questions unanswered. And usually it's so that there are so many dogmas in medicine and biology. If you look carefully into them, you find out that many of them do not hold up.
So your work, your research has a very high impact. So how did our contribution of your work in science work?
Well, of course, it's nice to see right now that the vaccination against papilloma virus has had a, hopefully, a very substantial impact. First of all, in preventing the precursor lesions of cervical cancer. Secondly, hopefully, which is not fully shown yet, but will be shown, I'm sure, in a couple of years, that it also prevents cervical cancer. Since cervical cancer in many parts of the world is one of the leading cancers in women, we feel that it is quite important to have these types of preventive measurements available. The only important aspect is that the vaccination has to be done prior to the onset of sexual activity, which means that young age groups between 9 and 14 years of age, and it has to be done also in boys and girls. Girls are usually the preferential target, but boys are as important because it transmits the virus quite effectively.
Yeah, I see. So, how do you think, how an ordinary child to become a great scientist? What is there any way to make?
One reason must be interest in the field,
yes.
Pre-existing interest in the field. Mm-hmm. Secondly, it is a question of hard work.
Yes.
I was saying it at one other occasion, that you start to work hard, to learn and to work harder later in life.
Yes.
And in addition, of course, you need to be willing and aware to think a little bit, in a horizontal direction, not always following the straight path of research, but find out which kind of sideways, hide some of those interests in data.
Yes. So in many ways. Mm. So as a scientist, if you have to convince people that do not trust in science or don't believe that the science can make real impact, so what are you going to say?
I wouldn't try to convince people who do not believe that science has no impact. I mean, that's hopeless for me. And so for those reasons, I like to talk to people and to convince people who have already a basic interest in it. If they don't have any interest, then I think it's not worth for them.
Okay. Thank you, Rim.
You're very welcome.
Hope you get something. Thank you for watching. Bye.
Sorry.